Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well. So, continuing with the last class of our general English, let's start our today's class. All right. So, in the last class of our general English, we started the poem "The Voice of the Rain" by Walt Whitman, and I did complete the first few lines from that poem. All right. And we did come to know that, you know, the voice of the rain, you know, was actually talking to the poet. All right, the rain was actually talking to the poet, and that's why it says the voice of the rain. All right, that's why the title says "The Voice of the Rain." So in the last class, we come to know about the comparison that was being made between the poem and the rain. All right, so through that comparison, we come to know that in both the cases, be it the poem or be it the rain, you know, both come back to its original position. All right, after giving fulfillment, after giving pleasure, after giving happiness to other living beings, all right, to other forms of life, after giving, you know, every kind of fulfillment, pleasure, joy and happiness, what happens is that both the poem of the poet and the rain, you know, it comes back to its original position. All right, so please see, that is page number 41. In the page 14, page number 41, the last line that we discussed in our last class was, "I am the poem of earth," said the voice of the rain. So when the poet asks, you know, to the soft falling shower, that "Who are you? Who art thou?" then in reply to that question, the rain, all right, the rain says that, you know, "I am the poem of earth," all right, said the voice of the rain. All right, after that you see, "Eternal I rise, impalpable, out of the land and the bottomless sea." Now here you will see that the rain actually says about its origin, all right, from where it origins, and it says itself to be eternal. So why eternal? Because it never dies. All right, eternal means which exists for lifelong, all right, which is everlasting, which can never end. All right, as we know that rain means water. All right, so water is what? Water is a part of nature, or so to say, it's nature itself. So can nature die? Can nature has got some kind of end to it? No, it doesn't, and that's why it says eternal. All right, now if question comes that what quality of the rain is being mentioned all, you know, through this poem, then what will be the answer? It will be eternal. All right, "I rise impalpable." Now you can see here that the rain has been given a human form, as we discussed earlier. All right, that's why rain keeps on saying here to be "I." Now normally "I" is the first person. All right, "I" is the first person, and we say "I" to a human being in order to denote a human being, a living being. All right, but here the rain is being referred to as "I." Why? Because so that the human beings, the readers, can relate himself or herself with the rain. All right, rain, which is a part of nature, all right, that is water. Without it we can't survive on this earth. There is no life without it. All right, so somewhere down the line we can say that our life is, you know, is connected with the rain only. All right, we are interdependent on each other. So that is what it says, "I rise impalpable out of the land." All right, I come out of the land and also from the bottomless sea, and here the rain is being described as impalpable. All right, why impalpable? Because it cannot be touched. When it comes out, you know, when it rises up to the sky in the form of water vapor, what happens? We can't touch it. All right, we can't feel it. All right, so that is what it says, that it cannot be touched. All right, that is the vapor of the water cannot be touched. So out of the land and the bottomless sea. So if question comes, you know, what is the origin of the rain? All right, where does the rain originate from? If question comes like that, the answer will be it rises out of the land and the bottomless sea. Next, you see, upward to heaven. Definitely, as a form, in the form of water vapor, it rises up to the sky. All right, it moves upward. That is upward where? Upward to heaven. Whence, vaguely formed, altogether changed, and yet the same. Now here in this line, we can see that, you know, different forms of rain is being mentioned here. All right, as we discussed earlier also, that water, when we boil it, it becomes boiling water. Water, when we cool it, it becomes cold water. Water, when we warm it a little bit, it becomes lukewarm water. All right, and that is what it says here. From where does it originate? It originates from the bottomless sea, from the land, all right, vaguely formed. You know, its shape, its formation is unclear. Why and how? Because we can't see it, we can't touch it. All right, as it is unclear, you know, the formation of that water, you know, the formation of that rain is unclear. We can't see it. You know, how does the rain comes? How does the rain actually come? We can't see it. We only know in theoretical way. All right, whatever theories we have read in science and all. So through that theoretical knowledge only we come to know that, you know, rain forms like this and like that. You know, there is a particular formation which has been set, you know, for the formation of the rain. We know that. Theoretically, we know that. But practically, we haven't seen that. How actually does the rain form? Alright, so that is what it says, that it is formed vaguely. It is unnoticeable. It can't be seen. Alright, altogether changed. So when it rises up to the heaven, when it rises up to the sky, it changes its form altogether. Because from the land, what happens? It moves up in the form of water vapor, then up in the heaven, it condenses. You know, that vapor that condenses, and again it comes back to the earth as rain droplets, water droplets. All right, so that process, you know, we can't see, though we know it theoretically. All right, so that is what it's being said here, that altogether change the form of that water. All right, that is changed, and yet the same. Whether be it vapor, whether it be boiling water, whether it be cold water, whether it be lukewarm water. But water in its original state is water only. Alright, if you suppose freeze, you know, if you freeze something in the freezer, alright, what happens? It becomes ice. Alright, when we freeze water in our freezer, what happens? In our fridge, what happens? That it becomes ice cubes. All right, then when it becomes warm, or when we take out that ice cubes, you know, those ice cubes from the freezer, what happened? It becomes water again. So ice cube is what? The original state of that ice cube is water only, though it changes its form. That's a different thing. But the original form, original state is water only. Alright, so that is what it says. That its form, vaguely formed, altogether changes, no doubt. Yet, it remains the same. Alright, its actual form, its original form remains the same. I descend to leave the droughts, atomies, dust layers of the globe. So what does it say here? What does the rain say here is that when I rises up to the sky, all right, I rises up to the heaven, then there I condense my form, and then I come back to the earth in the form of rain, all right, in the form of water droplets. And after coming from the sky, after coming from the heaven, when I come back to the earth, you know, there is actually a purpose behind the rain. You know, behind rain coming to the earth. and that purpose is being described in this line. All right, that I descend, I come down, you know, from heaven to earth in order to lave, that is to wash away the droughts, whatever, you know, dryness is there on this earth. You know, at times, what happens? We need water in a very large amount, all right, in order to various kinds of activities. For example, like for cultivation purpose, all right, even for our domestic purpose also, we need water, all right, at frequent intervals of time. So that is what it says, that I come back, I come down from heaven to the earth, you know, in order to fulfill, in order to fulfill the various activities of different life forms existing on this earth. All right, so that is what it says, I come down to wash, to lave, that means to wash the droughts, that is the dryness, in order to remove, take away the dryness that is there on the earth. Atomies here, small particles of dust, all right, small particles of every form of life, so to say. That is plants, you know, these, if you look around, what you see is that small plants, even, you know, trees, they also need water. All right, they also want water for their survival. All right, so that is what it says, in order to fulfill their work, in order to fulfill the activities of different life forms, dust layers of the globe, in order to wash away the dust layer of the globe, you know, that has been given, that has been giving, you know, a very harmful effect on the life of human beings. All right, so these are the purposes for which the rain come down from heaven to earth. All right, so if question comes that for what purpose does the rain descend from heaven, all right, if question comes like that, then you have to answer this. All right, it comes down, you know, to wash the droughts, atomies and dust layers of the globe. And forever, by day and night, I give back life to my own origin. Now, what does rain say here is that, you know, forever, whole day and night, I keep on giving, you know, life to every form of life existing on this earth, existing on this planet. And while coming down, what happens that I achieve, I get back to my original state only. Alright, so in the form of water vapor, it rises up, condenses there, it again comes back in the form of water droplets. Then again it comes back to the earth only, it comes back to the land only, it comes back to the bottomless sea only. Alright, so that is what it says, that I give back life to my own origin. This is very much needed. You know, the rain, the water has to come down. It has to come down. Otherwise, how could the river, sea, oceans, lakes will form? Alright? So, water is needed again for its own origin only. Alright? Rivers, oceans, seas, lakes, it can't be formed if water won't be there. Alright? It is only because of the water that these forms of life are actually forming. Okay, so that is what it says, that by day and night, all right, I give back life to my own origin and make pure and beautify it. And by giving my original position, you know, by giving my own origin, what happens is that I make everything beautiful. I make every form of life appear to be like youthful. Alright, I make every form of life youthful. I make it active. I bring back life to it. Okay. For song issuing from its birthplace after fulfillment, wandering, red door unbreak, duly with love returns. Now, this line is suggestive of what I said, you know, about the poem part. All right, whatever I discussed in the very first line itself, you know, when it replies, when the rain replies that I am the poem of earth. So that is what it says, you know, in the last two lines, that what is the function of a poem? A poem which is created by a poet, you know, it creates the poem so that the readers, you know, other people read the poem, all right, and enjoy it, rejoice it. Then after reading, going through the poem, after enjoying the poem, what do the readers do? They give back the poem, all right, to the poet in the form of appreciation, in the form of love. If they suppose like the poem, they appreciate it. People appreciate the poem. All right? So that is what it says, that wrecked or unwrecked. That means whether people read the poem, go through the poem, you know, whether people rejoices the poem or not, that doesn't matter much to the poet. All right? Because the main purpose of the poet to create the poem is just to share it. All right, the main purpose of the poet, you know, to create the poem is just to share it with other people, whether they like it or not. All right, so that is what it says. But most of the time what happens that the poet gets back love and appreciation from the people only, for whatever creation he has done, for whatever creativity, you know, he did. All right, in the form of poem. So I hope this poem is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do ask me. All right. So for today, let's stop here. And if possible, you please go through this poem once by yourself at home. All right. Then only you will be able to, you know, find out if you have any doubt or not. All right. So please go through the poem once by yourself at home. If you have any doubt, we shall discuss in, you know, in like, you can call me up also, you can message me. All right, so try to clear out the doubts. All right, so let's wind up. All of you, please take care and have a very nice and wonderful day ahead. Thank you.